Hello everybody. This input will give you an idea of what questions to ask in order to plan a meaningful, logical, and strategic evaluation for your science communication activity. For this, you'll find a template that helps you plan such an evaluation. And in this video, I'll explain what the questions posed in that template mean and how their answers are connected to another. The tool that we'll be working with was developed by the Impact Unit, a project from the German Organization for Science Communication, Wissenschaft im Dialog. The Impact Unit deals with questions around evaluation and impact in our field and is funded by the German Federal Ministry of Education and Research. Today we'll focus on the first steps to plan an evaluation, which are arguably the most important requirements in order to evaluate a project in a meaningful way. Because the rough sketch of your evaluation plan will give you an idea of how much effort the evaluation questions you are interested in will demand, and therefore how to allocate your time, personnel, and budgets accordingly. The decision tree for evaluation in science communication will give you an overview of the crucial questions one should think about. This is only a simplified version of that tree, with the basic questions that you will also find in your template. And it starts with the question, what is the evaluation trying to find out? To answer this, we start with identifying the motives of the evaluation. Most of the times, it's either about measuring if you met your goals and call a project successful, identifying how to improve certain processes in the future, or simply learning about your activities, how they work, who you reach, etc. And based on this, you'll formulate questions that your evaluation is supposed to answer. There are two different types of questions you can ask: an explanative or an explorative question. If you already have some prior knowledge regarding your question through previous evaluation or research or simply through experience with that type of SciComm or the target group, for example, then you might already have some theories or hypotheses in which direction the answer could go. That is an explanative question. The evaluation will challenge which of your hypotheses are right and which are wrong. If you have a question where you have no clear idea or no prior knowledge and therefore no set of plausible answers ready, then you have an explorative question where you literally explore unknown grounds. Once you have set on a motive, question, and maybe possible hypotheses, the following decisions will be based on this main interest. For example, you can decide on an evaluation design, which tells you how the evaluation is situated in your project. If the main interest revolves around the inner workings of the project, investigating its processes, if its motive is to give immediate feedback in order to change and improve an ongoing project, then a formative evaluation design is needed. That means the evaluation is an ongoing process accompanying the activity. If you are only interested in the end results, then a summative design is suitable. The focus will shift on the evaluation towards the end. But that does not mean you should only start thinking about the evaluation towards the end. It just means that your resources for evaluating, so the time for data collection and data analysis, will mostly be needed in this phase. We don't have to think of evaluation designs as strict categories, though. An evaluation can have more than one motive and many questions, and therefore interests in the formative and the summative range. We advise you to think about where your focus lies. Will your evaluation interests call for a mainly formative design, a mainly summative design, or are both equally important to you? The evaluation questions also reveal what data you need to collect in order to answer said questions. Simply put, if your evaluation question revolves around the thoughts and feelings of the people you reached, then their thoughts and feelings are the information of interest. Sometimes these objects in your question can be rather abstract. Then you have to develop indicators to make them measurable. For example, let's say you want to know the engagement of your target group with different scientific topics presented to them. That can be rather difficult to measure. Maybe measuring the time they spent in front of an info screen or on a quiz around that topic can be one of many indicators that help you get to the core of things. We advise you to only collect data that is helping you answer your evaluation question. everything else is cluttering your data sets. Once you know what data you need to collect, you can ask yourself where you find that data. Is it hidden in texts or articles? Is it stored in databases you access through web analytics? Or do certain people have access to it? If you can choose from different sources, ask yourself which is easy to access. For example, adults are often easier to involve in an evaluation than young children, and which source offers the most valid information. Then you get to choose your method for collecting the data from the preferred source. This is also the time to figure out which methodological approach you choose. The choice of methods depends on the type of information you need, because some things are easier to read from a text or ask from a person than to observe, and which method is fitting your source, because, for example, young children are easier to observe than to interview. We differentiate between direct data collection, so collecting, storing, analyzing information that is already presented to us, and indirect data collection that mostly requires talking to people. Whether you are going for a quantitative or qualitative approach for collecting and analyzing data will also affect the choice of methods. Many of them can be done either way, but some are better suited for one than the other, like qualitative interviews and quantitative web analytics. Whether you are posing an explanative or an explorative question also plays into that decision. Explorative questions can be more fitting for qualitative approaches. The template offers some guiding questions to support your decision. Finally, we get to the study design. It describes the strategy of how you collect data. Central questions are, how many times do I collect data? When should I collect the data? And how much data do I need to collect? To figure this out, you start asking if you need only a snapshot in time or if you want to examine a development. This answers the question around the number of measurements. If you are interested in the final rating of your project, then one measurement at the end of your project can be enough. But if you are interested in effects, then you are not interested in this final dot. In that case, you are interested in the line between the dots. This requires at least two measurements. And this first dot could be a measurement at an earlier point in time, or it could be a comparison group, like a control group. After that, you can decide on the right moment for the data collection. This depends on the type of information you are interested in and when it is accessible. And lastly, you'll ask yourself if you are able to collect all data of interest exhaustively, so ask all participants, read all the social media comments, etc., or if you are happy with a sample. Here you need to find the balance between sound, reliable results and the resources at your disposal. If you choose a sample, the strategy how to get to the sample is also a follow-up question to think about. And that's it. We hope this overview will give you some impulses for your next strategic evaluation plan, and you'll find more information on this tool and all our work at the Impact Unit on our website.